Hello students, and welcome back once again to another video for the class 9, numericals based on equations of motion. This is the question similar to the one that we did in the previous video. A motorbike achieves velocity of 36 km per hour in 20 seconds. So we have been given the time this time, 20 seconds, and the velocity that is 36. So it is not in minutes like before, already in seconds. So you don't need to convert every time into seconds. Observe the question carefully. Okay, because once we have the habit of converting everything, we convert seconds once again into seconds. So observe, if it is in minutes, then only you convert it in seconds. Find its acceleration and distance covered during this time. So the rest of the question is same. You just need to convert the velocity this time, okay? And once again, we will solve this numerical by both the equations, that is the second one and the third one. We have been given initial velocity as 0 meters per second because it is said that it achieves the velocity of 36. That means initially we have to take as 0. Now this is 36 kilometers per hour. Once again, we will convert this. What we get is V is 36 into 1000 by 1 into 60 into 60, because 1 hour is 60 minutes and then 60 seconds. So you remove the zeros and 6 into 6 is 36 and 36 get cancelled. So the only thing remaining is 10. So the velocity is 10 meters per second. Simple conversion. So 36 kilometers per hour is 10 meters per second. Now in 20 seconds is the time given, so we have the time as well. Simply find the acceleration and then we need to find the distance covered. So first, acceleration A is V minus U upon time taken. Simple, 20 minus 0 upon 20 seconds. So what you get is, 10, the final velocity is 10 meters per second, 10 minus 0 is 10, so 10 upon 20, zeros get cancelled, you get the answer as 1 by 2 meters per second square. So now that you have the acceleration, you can apply the second equation and the third equation, okay? Second equation is S is equal to 2t plus half at square. 2t plus half at square. U is 0 and 0 into time, whatever it is going to become 0. So I am writing 0 plus half. Acceleration is also half and time t is 20 seconds, so I am writing 20 seconds whole square. Now 0 plus any number is 0, so it is going to remain the same. So S is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into 20 into 20, because 20 square is 10 into 20. 2 into 10 becomes 20, into 10 is half, 20. So 10 into 10 becomes 100. So the answer is 100 meters. Now similarly, you will have to get the same answer if we use the third equation as well. Once again, we apply the third equation, that is 2as is equal to v square minus u square. Once again, you apply the values. Acceleration is 1 by 2. S, that is displacement, you need to find. V square is 10 square minus initial velocity is 0 square. Okay, so this gets answered. 2 ones and 2. 1 into S is S. 10 square is 100. 10 into 10 is 100 minus 0, because 0 square is 0. Therefore, displacement is 100 meters. Once once again, students, you can see that the answer is same for both the equations. Okay? But the important thing is you will need to find the acceleration first in order to use the equation. Now, sometimes it may be possible that you might be given the velocity and the question might be asked that you need to find the time taken. So, you will have to go the this numerical or solve this numerical in reverse. You might be given velocity, then you can find the acceleration. Once you find the acceleration from the third equation, then you can apply those values of displacement in the second or the first equation. Because after finding acceleration, you can apply the value in this one directly. There is no need to make it confusing for this one. Okay? So if displacement might be given, then you can find the acceleration with the help of velocity from the third one, and then you can apply those values over here so you can get the value of time taken. This numerical can be solved in that way as well. Okay? I hope that is clear to you, students. Quite simple.